measure the distance to stars? Unfortunately, if you tried to use a ridiculously long ruler, the ruler would be gravitationally pulled in the direction of the star or some other object in space, and would disintegrate if it ever somehow got close enough to the star. Astrophysicists have long since been forced to think outside the sphere. First and foremost, astronomers take advantage of geometry to calculate distance. This method of measurement is called parallax, or triangulation. Depending on where you are, stars shift relative to the background stars, i.e. stars that are much farther away. When the Earth is on one side of the Sun, you will see a star at a slightly different angle than when the Earth is on the other side of the Sun. We take advantage of these angles and the known distance between the Earth and the Sun, 1 AU, which is short for astronomical unit, to determine the distance to the star. The closer the star is to our solar system, the more it will seemingly move against the background stars. If we compare where a star is on an image 1 month relative to where it is 6 months later, when the Earth is on the other side of the Sun, we can measure a parallax angle. The parallax angle is half of the star's apparent motion across the sky. We can then say that the sine of the parallax angle is equal to 1 AU over the distance from the Earth to the star. For large distances, like the distance to a star, the sine of an angle is approximately equal to the angle itself. Thus, we simply say the distance to the star is equal to 1 AU over the parallax angle. If you instead calculated the distance between the Sun and the star using the tangent of the angle, you'd get approximately the same value. Now, the units of this may be slightly different from what you're used to. Because everything in astrophysics comes in such large or small scales, astronomers use their own set of units. An arcsecond is 1/60th of an arc minute, which is 1/60th of a degree, so an arcsecond is 1/3600th of a degree. For distance, we use a unit called parsec, which is equivalent to the distance to a star with only one arcsecond. So the distance to a star written in parsecs is simply 1 divided by the parallax angle in arcseconds. Let's run through an example. The parallax angle to Proxima Centauri, the closest star to us besides the Sun, is 0.76813 arcseconds. If we divide that by 1, we get a distance of about 1.302 parsecs. 1 parsec is equivalent to about 3.261 light years, so we can multiply 1.302 parsecs by 3.261 to say Proxima Centauri is about 4.246 light years away. Astronomers also use Cepheid variable stars to determine distance. Cepheids are stars that have very consistent, fluctuating levels of brightness. In 1912, Henrietta Swan Leavitt discovered that the period of these fluctuations in brightness is related to the star's luminosity, or intrinsic brightness. We can relate a star's luminosity to the star's apparent brightness on Earth, also known as flux, to calculate a star's distance. We aptly call this relationship between a star's apparent and intrinsic brightness the flux-luminosity equation. We can measure a star's flux from Earth, and we can use the period of Cepheid variable stars to get a luminosity. Once we have both the flux and the luminosity of an object, we can plug these variables into the flux-luminosity equation to get a distance. There are a couple of other ways of determining distance, but parallax and the flux-luminosity formula are by far the most common. Feel free to leave any questions you have on this topic below, and thanks for tuning in.